things on you. Ooh, you know, I convinced my dog that he got to stay in the house. And guess what? Nobody came to the house, but I bet you he had my house. He had my house and neighbor's house. He don't go no farther than that because he been convinced that this is home. And he had no leash on him, but he's been convinced that this is home. And when we are in the world, when we come out of the world and we are of God, God says, I'm taking off every stronghold. I did everything. I give you the right to pull everything out. You ain't got no chains on you, but you let people put chains on you. Because when a person's mind is full of their strongholds and past experience and word curses and their actions are derived from their heart, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So sometimes that's why we talk about ourselves so much, people talk about us so much. Those are word curses that you ain't gonna be nothing. You ain't nobody like your daddy, just like your mama. Your family ain't never did you nothing. You never did anything in this world. And with this word curses come upon us, we let our past experiences come upon us. And Lord, I failed this time, and I failed that time. God said, a righteous man, I'm gonna hit you. He falls 7 times, but he gets back up. Y'all, this is what the word says about you. Tell you that you waste your time trying to act like you all saved and have it all together and play the part for the people when your mind is full of disobedience to what God says. I'm preaching to me. I'm preaching to anybody who needs this out here. And sometimes we look like we're so saved, but we ain't doing nothing God told you to do. We've been ignoring God for the last 10 years. I gotta preach against myself. There's some stuff that God told me to do. He said, look, I want to bless you abundantly above. You think you happy with this, but that ain't what I want you to have. I want you to have more. But I've been disobedient in my mind to what God has told me to do. And then God said, I cannot work in your disobedience. God preached to me. You can be quiet. God. Get this. You see, God does not want robots that simply comply with his will. He wants to pull down the stronghold of your mind. That's why the word says to let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Jesus' flesh was not just compliant to the will of God. His mind was in line with the will of God. Everybody hear me? And so he can put God's will over his will, and that's what set him apart. The pain that he would endure on the cross would take more than a willing body. Oh, the willing body will keep you up there. We always say, it's mind over matter. If you don't mind, it don't matter. It's not the physical, it's what's in your mind. Yeah. I was talking to a young man going to basic training. He was saying, I got to keep myself in shape. And he already in shape. I said, man, it don't matter if you're in shape. It's not a physical battle. It's a mental battle. It's who you are when things get bad. Because if you really want to go, you're going to keep on going. My sister played basketball under Coach Deidre Hosey. And Deidre Hosey was known to run them like crazy. Y'all better hear me. She was known that when tryouts came, all she did was make them run. And whoever couldn't run didn't make the team. Y'all better hear me. That's how you figure out who won't be a part of it. But you know, even though sometimes she felt hurt in her body, it wasn't a willing body that kept her there. But it was a willing mind that keeps you running. That's real talk right now. You see, it will require a renewed and made up mind. The weight of the assignment on your life will take more than a willing mind. It's more than a yes, Lord. I know I didn't preach yes, Lord before. Y'all forgive me. I'm sorry. You know, I say I'll do the yes, Lord. But sometimes the next level, God said, I want more than a yes, Lord. I want a yes in your heart. Hey, I want a yes in your mind. I want your mind to be made up the way I am. I want the mind that was in Christ to be inside of you. I need more than a yes, Lord. I need more than to say, Lord, I'm going to do it. You know, I want to do it. I want you to want to do it. I want my will to be your will. I want you to make up your mind that if it's for God, I'll do whatever God says for me to do. And I want to do what God wants me to do.
Yeah.
It's a level that says, Lord, I don't want to be compliant. Just say, yes, Lord, even though I want to do it. But it's another level where God says, I want you to want to do it.
Yeah, preach that right there.
Ah! You want to hear that one? Because that's easy. Sometimes I say, Lord, I want to do it, but I'm going to do it. God said, I want you to want to do it. Oh, I'm a man inside there. I'm a married man. I've learned something. They don't want you to say yes. They want you to want to do what they want you to do. Key, I'm telling you, it's something else. I don't know what about y'all women. Y'all ain't just happy with me. Y'all just saying, yeah, we'll go. You want us to want to do what you want us to do. Ain't that something else? And that's the thing with me sometimes. We want y'all to want want a yes, Lord, in your heart. I want a yes, Lord, in your mind. I want my will to be your will. Y'all better hear me this time. Come down a little bit. The weight of your assignment in your life will take more than a willing body. It's going to take an obedient mind. Let me get out of here, because it is time to revenge, take revenge on disobedience. Paul states that the church must have a readiness to revenge our disobedience. He is speaking on a holistic and an organizational level, but this can also be used on a personal level as well. We have to have a readiness to revenge all disobedience. We have to develop a godly anger and our disobedience to the voice of God. Too often we get comfortable with disobeying God, because our disobedience sometimes is always private. And sometimes we get to a point, we get comfortable telling God, I ain't gonna do this. We get comfortable telling God, I ain't gonna do that. We get comfortable being disobedient to God because what he told us, you didn't hear. And because you didn't hear it, and because God will automatically strike us down by disobedience, we get comfortable in our disobedience, don't we? However, if we're going to be really used by God and blessed by our relationship with God, we have to develop a spirit of obedience to the voice of God. And it has to really trouble us when we can blatantly disobey his voice. God had to shake me. He said, Daniel, you get too comfortable doing what you want to do. You get too comfortable not obeying my voice. You get too comfortable, well, Lord, I'll do it next weekend. Lord, I'll do it next Monday. And I'll do it when I get time. He said, Daniel, you get too comfortable telling me no. We don't want to hear that, because we won't think that God always understands. But God says, I get tired of my people who get comfortable not doing what I tell them to do. Am I preaching to somebody inside of here? That God has to do. If God ain't telling you, then you probably ain't saved. I'm gonna be real right now. I'm going to let a spade call spade a spade. If God ain't told you to do nothing and try to pull you to a higher level, you probably ain't saved. Because if you really saved, he's always pulling you. Pulling you. I need more from you. I did that last week, God. I need more from you. I was reading more than that. I need more from you. He's always calling you out. He said that we are the ecclesia. We are the called out people. And the more he calls you out, the more he puts you in a place where you got to say, Lord, I say yes, Lord, to you. But sometimes we get comfortable telling God no. See, when we ignore the voice of God and do our own thing and it not bother us, we're in real trouble. We have to deal with our disobedience. Disobedience has consequences. When we obey God, we have to understand that we can repent. When we disobey God, we have to understand that we can repent. But sometimes we still have to live with the consequences. Hear me. And some consequences are permanent. Sometimes there's some blessings you're going to miss that ain't coming back around. I'm not being real with you in the house. You get mad at me, what applies to you applies to me too. Your soul may be saved and your spirit may be restored, but your life can be changed forever because of your disobedience. People have lost out on their destiny due to a decision to be disobedient to God. God said, I want you to do this, but I can't trust anybody who's going to tell me no. So therefore, if you won't do it, your destiny is gone. I got to change what I want you to be now. We don't like that. We don't believe that. We don't believe that sometimes what we do can mess us up. If you don't believe that, look at Saul. The Bible says, and then we think, God never chose Saul. People chose Saul. That we think, right? That's a lie. Bible don't say that. Bible says that Samuel had anointed Saul to be king before the people even saw him. Read the Bible. Read the way it said. He said, no. He told Samuel to anoint this man to be king, and then the people saw him later on. So God was giving Saul the same chance he gave David. He told Saul, he said, look, I'm going to make your whole family kings too. But because Saul was disobedient to God, he said, I told you a king would be sitting here forever. But because of your disobedience, because you hurt the people and not hurt me, he said, it's going to end with you. It's really quiet. We don't like the consequences, do we? Then Moses was a man of God, a great man of God, did great things for God. And God said, speak to the rock, to the water, to break and bring forth water. And the Bible says, he got there with the people, he struck the rock. And God said, because you did that, he said, you don't see the promised land, but you never walk in it. That's what he said. Go read the Bible. That's exactly what he said. He said, you will see the promised land, but you will never walk in it. Because I can't have a leader. Oh, I'm going to preach to myself. I'm going to preach to people inside. I can't have people leading their families who won't do what people tell them to do and not what I tell them to do. I can't have people leading churches. I can't have people leading ministries who won't